When they first announced Genshin Impact, I remember the outcries of people on social media yelling that this was an exact copy of Breath of the Wild, both stylistically and mechanics-wise. Well, let me ask you this. Is yellow mustard the same as Dijon mustard? No, but they kinda do the same job though. You can't really deny it. That's how I would compare Genshin Impact to Breath of the Wild. So, no, it's not entirely the same. Genshin Impact is a free-to-play game from Chinese studio miHoYo, who are commonly known as solely mobile game developers. So, this game is not only a beautiful cel-shaded masterpiece, it's also an almost impossible feat to believe given that you wouldn't expect this level of quality from a mobile developer. Genshin Impact pretty much plays like any other open-world action-adventure game. You got a weapon, almost always a sword, and you get to explore the world, kill enemies, liberate areas, activate fast travel transportation ports, glide from place to place, use the world's elements to your advantage, discover and complete temples teeming with complex puzzles, fighting giant robotic guardians. Wait, hold on. This game is actually very similar to Breath of the Wild now that I think about it. No, wait. I can't fall into that trap. It's too easy. Instead, I'll go over what Genshin Impact does better in comparison to Breath of the Wild and how it underperforms in comparison to Breath of the Wild in certain elements. First off, the combat. The combat in this game at first seemed to be just like any other action-adventure game. You attack with a button, dodge enemies' attacks, and have heavier attacks at your disposal. However, in this game, your characters each have different elemental abilities that they can use that are more or less effective on certain enemies. For example, Pyro is very effective against Cryo and triggers the melt effect on enemies. This melt makes it so your attack deals way more damage than it usually does. Here's a chart that better explains every single element's effects, strengths, and weaknesses. This information, of course, can be found in the Genshin Impact fandom site, which I'll link down below because there's just so many elements and there's just so many different ways that they work with each other that, I mean, it's basically its own Pokemon game at this point. Aside from these new mechanics, you can easily swap between characters. So battle never actually comes to a full stop in case you need to fully readjust your plan of attack. However, one downside to the combat is that it turns from a strategic mode of gameplay when you're arriving to a certain enemy camp into a full-blown button-mashing mess as soon as you start attacking your enemies. What Breath of the Wild did way better than Genshin Impact is that there are a multitude of ways to kill an enemy or clear out a camp. And to an extent, you do have the elements on your side. However, something that Genshin Impact doesn't have is the physics engine. So using objects such as metal boxes or big spiky balls are out of the picture. There is also a complete lack of stealth in Genshin Impact. The only way into a battle is going in recklessly and attacking enemies or blowing up an explosive barrel. This then pushes you into what I just talked about, a full-on button mashing session. Now, don't get me wrong, the button mashing can be hectic, it can be fun, it can be dynamic, and it can be thrilling. But it does get boring when all you can do is attack head on. I don't know, maybe I'm just a fan of stealth-based games. Now, besides the combat, the game also has you completing a multitude of tasks. Side missions that require combat, temples filled with puzzles that, in all honesty, are very well designed, and searching for clues to find a person responsible for causing mischief are all part of the game. It was honestly a very nice surprise to see that this game had a wide variety of things to do in the game. Additionally, whenever you clear a camp or find a chest, you receive several different items that can be used for upgrading your weapons, and these artifacts grant you upgraded abilities such as upgraded health bars and higher crit chances. And this is where I kinda started to fall out of love with the game. At the beginning, the game makes it very easy to level up. But like extremely easy. You get these sort of cards, I don't know what to call them, that basically grant you experience points. And they really give you a lot of these throughout the game. After less than 5 hours, I was able to reach level 20 on all four of my characters, and I obviously became too overpowered for the enemies, to the point where I was beating pretty high level enemies with almost no issue. Of course, some of my gameplay skills played a part in that. But this made the game turn into a very grindy experience with almost no reward. And if I didn't already mention it, this game is crossplay, so you can complete missions with players from other platforms, which kind of adds a more engaging level to the gameplay. If I were to compare it to Breath of the Wild, at least in Breath of the Wild, the difficulty was scalable with you. And I've actually done a full-on video on video game difficulty that I'll link up here above, and I use Breath of the Wild as an example of how Breath of the Wild implements scalable difficulty. Only at the very end of Breath of the Wild is when you start to really plow through enemies, and even then a guardian can very much easily take you out with a few lasers. Next, we have what is this game's biggest quality, but at the same time it's worst. So I'm a little torn on this element of the game. The game's graphics are without a doubt beautiful. Time passes and cel-shaded games still age very nicely. I mean, Wind Waker still looks beautiful, especially in HD. Everything from the characters to the environments, the lighting, everything looks very, very nice. However, my main issue with the art style is that the anime-inspired characters clash a lot with the environments. I don't know, to me they seem like they don't quite fit in this world. I mean, for God's sakes, the female characters, some of them have, I don't know what to call them, but unrealistic boob physics. I mean, come on. If that doesn't say anime inspired, then I don't know what will. So, even though the game looks great, these sort of things, these anime inspired choices stylistically, do kind of take me out of the game experience. I may just not be the demographic for it, but you be the judge. With Breath of the Wild, everything in the world seemed to fit and work together so nicely. Everything from the architecture, the advanced Sheikah technology, the environments, the NPCs, and even the animals all seem to be part of the same world. It's something that I can't really quite explain, and I honestly urge you to download Genshin Impact and find out for yourself. In addition to these issues with the art style and graphics, the main issue I ran when playing Genshin Impact was the optimization. I played this game on my base PS4. Yes, we are broke boys out here. And I ran into constant frame drops, elements popping in here and there, and constant stuttering. I've seen people stream this game from a PC with almost no issue, so yeah, it must be my very own hardware because, well, the game does run mobile. Did I mention that this game is on iOS and Android? Yeah, you can play this game on your phone for free. Like I said, this game is an impressive feat. Now, I'm not too sure if the delays I did experience were an issue of the game or more so my connectivity, because I don't think I mentioned this, but this game is always online. Yes, you need an internet connection to play this game. I experienced some lag when it came to button presses and movement, which then led me to believe if internet connectivity was the actual issue and not so much the game. I mean, I have pretty good internet, but if it's not the internet, then it probably was the optimization, at least for PS4. As much as I like this game, the biggest negatives from this game are the microtransactions and that it is a gacha game. And that kind of explains the need to be connected to the internet throughout the whole game. Now, this is a free game and a company has to make their money. I understand fully, but gacha mechanics just never sat right with me, given that you may not always get what you pay for. I mean, that's half of the fun of gacha though, right? But it's not something that I find particularly enticing to spend money on. Obviously, Breath of the Wild didn't have these issues. Hell, Breath of the Wild isn't even an online game. There's no multiplayer, there's no gacha mechanics, there's no microtransactions. There was DLC, but that's a whole other story. In conclusion, no. This game is not a Breath of the Wild copy. Is it inspired by Breath of the Wild? Well, yes, of course. I mean, just look at the trailer. But much like Breath of the Wild was inspired by other games such as Skyrim, I'm sure, the issue here isn't that there is a hint of similarity with the art styles. The issue many people seem to conflate with this game is that Genshin Impact took elements from Breath of the Wild and built upon them. Whether that be stamina bars, whether that be open world exploration, hell, whether that be even the environment art style. Genshin Impact built upon those elements. That's it. And that's something that should be commended and shouldn't be attacked, in my opinion. Criticized, sure, but met with hate, that's a little bit too excessive. No idea is fully original nowadays. Anything that might be considered a new idea is something that was built upon and inspired by older ideas. Innovators take old ideas, reshape them to their advantage, and then create great things into existence. Genshin Impact is its own thing. It's not a copy. All right, art is subjective. That's the whole point of the video then. But I recommend you go out and play this game. It's free to play. You're not losing anything if you go and download it. So go ahead and download it. It's free for PC, PS4, and mobile devices. And it's crossplay. So just try it out. Just try it out, straight up. Why are you even watching this video? Folks, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Links to my socials are down below. Please make sure to follow me on Twitch, where I've recently become affiliated, and any and all support is greatly appreciated. And with that, I leave it off to you. Have you played Genshin Impact? What do you think of the game? Do you think it's an exact carbon copy of Breath of the Wild? Or do you think it's just a game inspired by Breath of the Wild? In my opinion, it's a fun game. I don't know if I'll continue playing it just because I'm not too fond of the gacha mechanics, but it's something to hold us off until Breath of the Wild 2 and Age of Calamity. Please take care of each other, but most importantly, take care of yourself. Peace.